Conte West. And if the Celtics score a couple of times to close this gap, I can convince my guys, hey, I trust you. I'm just putting LeBron back in the ball.
Brian Scalabrini has a game for the first time tonight for the Celtics. Pierce gets the bounce. Paul Pierce with nine. And you can imagine if Pierce gets up, that might be the quickest reason for Mike Brown to get LeBron back into the game, because LeBron has helped Pierce in check all night.
Hey, listen, those players got no problem if LeBron James comes back into the game. They're over there saying, hey, put LeBron back in, folks.
He's one guy who will look you straight in the eye and say, this is the best bunch of guys I've ever been around. I know everybody says that about every team they're on. But Mike Brown talked about it to us this morning. Training camp, 10 or 12 of them going out for dinner on the road. 10 or 12 of them going to a movie going out for dinner. This is a group that really seems to have come together. No trades this year, no holdouts, and they're really enjoying each other's company.
I go out, too. If LeBron was always paying. You know what I mean? He's got all that money. I'm going out. Okay. But I do think that has something to do with on-court chemistry. But I've been on part of great teams that didn't go out that frequently on the road. As long as you play with good on-court chemistry, that's the biggest thing.
You sure they just didn't go out and get a phone call?
No, I'm not saying coaching for the food.
Well, last year, think about the Boston Celtics and how the so-called Big Three, that was the topic of discussion all last season. But there were a lot of times where the Big Three, when they were interviewed, Kevin Garnett was more than anybody, wanted to talk about all 12 guys. They wanted to talk about Rondo, the Perkins, the Cozy, and things like that. And maybe the big one, the game with Cleveland, maybe he's having the same kind of impact on that.
No, I think that is important. When everybody figures they have an important role, no matter what that role is. And I think that the best players on a team speak so highly about the players that they're playing with is so very important.
And I think an unselfish attitude doesn't just start on the offensive end, on the defense, it also starts off the floor. So when you begin to say, I made my money on LeBron James, I have the recognition, I can shove some of that towards the rest of you guys getting it done, and that goes a long way towards completing the basketball.
Barajow, this is the first 12-point lead for Cleveland. Another good night for Barajow. Once Gauskas gets back, Barajow playing with a lot of confidence in the offensive end. Rotation to Barajow, Wallace, and El Gauskas up front. Hickson, DB, that's a pretty good group of big guys for this football.
And I really like when they finish games with LeBron James at the four. And three-point shooters around him. I really think that's a difficult thing to guard.
Pierce over Zerbiak, and LeBron stands up, waiting for Mike Brown to look at him. Mike Brown didn't, so LeBron sat back down.
Oh, you're full pitch. Your eyes are lighting up right now because you are allowed to get somewhat of a rhythm having Wallace Zerbiak defending with all due respect. But LeBron James has to get back in this ballgame.
And LeBron was dripping, was coming back in. Wallace trying to answer at the other end. Here come the Celtics. Here comes LeBron. Heading to the scorer's table. Pierce. Got the miss. Missed again. Oh, inside and one. And it all began again with Paul Pierce sensing the advantage he had on Wally Zerbiak and forcing the issue.
Outstanding energy and effort by Pierce, getting into the thick of the Cavs defense, and then second and third opportunities, and folks have outfinished it. Get the big guys in the air to shot block it, throw the body up, hit the basket, going to the line for the possible three-point.
Jeff, now Mike Brown has gone to the lineup you talked about as LeBron James is in there at the four, along with Barajow and then the three small guards. Except here comes Ben Wallace. We'll see what he takes.
Well, with Garnett back in the game, that would have been a difficult cover for LeBron James. They probably could have played him on pole.
I think the reason why you go with the two bigs in this scenario is because defensively, they're going to be in a position to help LeBron James defend the pole fist. Defensively is where they have to
be. And I love Doc Rivers' decision to play Paul Pierce and Ray Allen. Basically, the whole second half, that's the only way you're going to win the game. Their bench doesn't have the firepower without one of those or both of those guys on the floor. particularly in the fourth quarter.
Five on the shot clock. LeBron, a long two. Lost the ball.